The scope of a variable is the area in code which the variable can be used in. A variable is said to be local to the place in code that it can be used. Code blocks are generally what defines a variable's scope, and these are denoted by braces. For example, everything within the class here can be said to be local to that class. You would say that the variables alpha, beta, and gamma are in scope within the scope and access modifiers class. And you would say that the pens, crayons, and answer variables are in scope within the example function. Let's talk about public and private access modifiers. Variables defined in the class, as opposed to those declared within a function, have an access modifier attributed to them. An access modifier is a keyword placed before a data type when declaring the variable, and its purpose is to define where the variable or function can be seen from. As a general rule, if other scripts need access to a variable or function, then it should be public. Otherwise, it should be private. Declaring a variable as public means that it can be accessed from outside the class. It also means that the variable is shown and editable on the component in the inspector. In this example, my scope and access modifier script is applied to our skatebot object. And you can see that the public variable alpha is included as a property that I can edit. This allows the user to edit the variable while they test the game. Imagine, for example, the value controls the speed of a car. It would be nice to be able to tweak that variable while testing it without having to stop, edit the script, and play again. As such, it makes sense to have this be a public variable. Note that if a variable is initialized in the class to a default value, for example, if we had put alpha equals 5, then it will still be overridden by the value that's written in the inspector. However, if these values are set in functions, such as start and awake, these occur after the variable has been set in the inspector and will not be overridden by the inspector. So, for example, if my script had a default value of 5 but was being overridden by the inspector and then setting it manually in the start function, that will override the value that was input in the inspector. Now, given that the game is running, if I tweak the value again, that will override the value in the script again. Importantly, the values modified via the inspector while the game is in play mode will be reset and not saved in the inspector when we exit play mode. Even though the public variable is tweakable on the component, it doesn't mean that you can't go back and change it via a script at runtime. Private variables can only be edited from within the class. In C#, private is the default access modifier for any variable that doesn't have it specified. So, although I've written private on beta and gamma, if I hadn't, they would be private regardless. It's good practice to make all member variables, those that belong to a class rather than a function, private, unless they need to be public for a specific reason. Setting variables and functions to public can also mean that you can access them from other scripts. So, for example, I have another class here which has two functions in a public function called fruit machine and a private function called office sort. I also have some public variables and some private variables. Back in my original script, I can only access the public members of that script. For example, if I were to create an instance of the class another class, you can see that when I try and access this, the apple and banana variables, as well as fruit machine, are available. And you can see that IntelliSense in Visual Studio is telling me that I can use these. When I choose Fruit Machine, it's then showing me what arguments can be fed in to that function. Now, I can feed in any of the variables that are in scope for this script or that are in scope of another class because they're public. So, I could use any of the variables from my Scope and Access Modifiers class, and I can access the instance of another class and make use of a public variable from there, such as apples, for example. Note that because Office Sort and Stapler and Cellotape are all private, I can't access them by creating an instance of another class. They are for use only within that class itself.